I don't know how my story will end, but in no chapter will it say that I ever gave up. My name is Jennifer Myers. I'm 51 years old. I have stage 4 metastatic cervical cancer. I was someone that faithfully went to my doctor, got all of my, you know, wellness checks, all of my exams, preventive, everything. But I was spotting and had some irregular bleeding, and I felt it was just something that just didn't seem right. Within the examination, he felt that there was something there that he wanted to biopsy, and that's how they found the cervical cancer. I was first diagnosed in 2014, and I was stage 1, had a surgery and 5 internal radiations, and I was cleared. It did return in 2017, and at that point it was in my pelvic wall, so they had decided surgery was not an option, so I did 7 weeks of radiation and 6 chemo treatments, and once again was cleared. Within a year, it came back a third time and it metastasized into my lymphatic system as well as some lung nodules that they were concerned about. It is a whirlwind. If you've never had cancer, you don't understand it's a whirlwind, and you want it to be a whirlwind. You want it, your doctors not to wait months or weeks, but it doesn't give you time sometimes to really realize until after it's over what had happened and what you had gone through. My husband was brave enough to ask the question, you know, what are our options? And my doctor was very clear that if I did nothing, I had a few months. If I went with traditional, best guess would be 15 months. He recommended I go to a facility that has a lot of options like targeted therapy, clinical trials, and that's what led me to where I am today. It started at MD Anderson in November of 2018, and I went through some chemo, but it was too harsh for my body. So they put me into this clinical trial, which I was in a phase 1 clinical trial at MD Anderson for 30 months. And it was very successful. But they felt my lung nodules were getting a little bit larger than they had wanted, and they felt being in the trial for 30 months, my body had just gotten used to the treatment, and they wanted to look at some different things, including a Tivdak trial. What attracted me to that is the fact it was just FDA approved, and he really felt it was the best shot I had. And the fact that it is designed specifically for metastatic cervical cancer, which is what I have, and I just felt really strongly his recommendation of Tivdak was the best course of action. It's an infusion, so I still go to MD Anderson. This time I only go every 3 weeks. Tivdak, you know, is the typical chemo that you would think of. So I'm navigating through the side effects of the actual treatment. Nothing that, you know, I would say is life altering. I do have a great team at MD Anderson that really helps me manage those side effects and those symptoms that I have. Being in a clinical trial was very eye-opening, and I just feel like there's so many people, unsung heroes in the cancer world, that are out there trying to make these new drugs and trying to do this targeted therapy and trying to look at your body and see how your genetic makeup can help cure the cancer. What you do day in and day out does impact somebody. I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for people that did trials or new drugs. I was given 15 months in November of 2018, and we are now in 2022. And, you know, a lot of that has to do with the treatments and the trial that I went through and, you know, the types of things that the doctors that I've entrusted to take care of me. But I would say to members of Congress, it is something that I believe wholeheartedly, maybe not in my lifetime, but I hope in my niece and nephews or my great nieces and nephews' lifetime, that cancer is something that isn't thinking, when am I gonna die? I want you people to think that it could be manageable, and it's not going to happen unless help just given to these brilliant people out here that are sitting in labs and are, you know, researching day in and day out to find ways to cure someone like me. I'm not smart enough to do that. More than happy to be the person that can help them achieve those goals.